Hello, Namaste, myself M.S. Basargon, learning outcome. At the end of this session, students will be able to solve homogeneous linear differential equations. Now, solve x cube dqy by dx cube minus 2x dy by dx plus 4y equal to 0. Pause the video for a while and find the solution of this equation. I hope you have completed. Here given equation is x cube dqy by dx cube minus 2x dy by dx plus 4y equal to 0, which is a clearly a homogeneous linear equation. Now to solve the homogeneous equation, we have to put x equal to e raised to z, that is z is equal to log x, so that x dy by dx is equal to dy, where d stands for d by dz, and x cube dqy by dx cube is equal to d into d minus 1 into d minus 2 of y. Now putting these values in the given equation, we get d into d minus 1 into d minus 2 minus 2d plus 4 of y equal to 0. That is, by simplifying this expression, we get d cube minus 3d square plus 2d and minus 2d plus 4 of y equal to 0. That is, d cube minus 3d square plus 4 of y equal to 0, which is a linear differential equation with constant coefficients, and its auxiliary equation is f of d equal to 0. That is, d cube minus 3d square plus 4 is equal to 0. Now factors of this cubic polynomial are d plus 1 into d minus 2 whole square is equal to 0. That is, we get the roots as a d equal to minus 1, 2 and 2. Here one of the root is real and distinct, remaining two roots are real and repeated. Therefore the complementary function is given by cf is equal to c1 e raised to minus z plus, for repeated root, c2 plus c3z into e raised to 2z. Now here the right hand side of the given equation is 0, therefore the required solution is only cf. That is, required solution is y equal to c1 e raised to minus z plus into bracket c2 plus c3z into e raised to 2z, which is the solution of the equation number 1. To get the solution of the original equation, we can put z is equal to log x, that is x equal to e raised to z. We get the required solution of the given equation. Now we will solve more different types of examples on homogeneous equations. You take example number 1, solve x d square y by dx square minus 2y by x is equal to x plus 1 by x square. Now if you look at this equation, here the equation is not homogeneous, it is not satisfying the definition of homogeneous equation. To get a homogeneous equation, multiply given differential equation both side by x. We get x into x, that is x square d square y by dx square minus 2 into y by x into x, x will get cancelled, that is you get minus 2y, which is equal to x into x, that is x square plus 1 by x square into x, that is plus 1 by x. Now clearly the given equation is now reduced to homogeneous linear equation. To solve the homogeneous linear equation, again we can put x is equal to e raised to z, that is z is equal to log x, so that x dy by dx is equal to d of y, and x square d square y by dx square is equal to d into d minus 1 of y, where d stands for here d by dz. Now substituting all these values in the given equation, we get d into d minus 1, that is the value of x square d square y by dx square minus 2 of y equal to e raised to 2z plus 1 by e raised to z. By simplifying, we get d square minus d minus 2 of y is equal to e raised to 2z plus e raised to minus z. Let us call this as equation number 1. Now, which is a linear differential equation with constant coefficients. and its auxiliary equation is given by f of d equal to 0, means d square minus d minus 2 is equal to 0. Now factors of this quadratic polynomial are d plus 1 into d minus 2 equal to 0, that is we get d equal to minus 1 and 2. Here both the roots are real and distinct, therefore the complementary function can be written as cf is equal to c1 e raised to minus z plus c2 e raised to 2z. Now we'll calculate pi. Pi is equal to 1 by f of d. Here f of d is d square minus d minus 2 of e raised to 2z plus e raised to minus z. Now we can separate into two parts, which is equal to 1 by d square minus d minus 2 of e raised to 2z plus 1 by d square minus d minus 2 of e raised to minus z. Now here we can replace d by a, means d by 2 here, and if replaced by d by 2 here, what we get? 0. Therefore we can multiply by z and we can differentiate the polynomial, that is 1 by 2d minus 1 of e raised to 2z plus, again here also we can multiply by z, and derivative of the polynomial is 1 by 2d minus 1 into e raised to minus z. Since we know 1 by f of d of e raised to ax is equal to x into 1 by f dash of d of e raised to ax if f of a equal to 0. Here f of a is 0, therefore we apply this rule. Now which is equal to z into, now we can replace here d by 2, that is 2 into 2 minus 1 of e raised to 2z plus z into, here we can replace d by minus 1, that is 2 into minus 1 minus 1 of e raised to minus z. Now which is equal to z by 3 e raised to 2z minus z by 3 e raised to minus z. Hence the complete solution of the reduced equation, that is equation number 1, is y equal to cf plus pi. That is here y equal to cf is c1 e raised to minus z plus c2 e raised to 2z plus this pi. Here you have taken z by 3 common, z by 3 into bracket e raised to 2z minus e raised to minus z. Now to get the solution of original equation, we can put z is equal to log x or e raised to z is equal to x. We get y equal to c1 e raised to minus z, we will get x raised to minus 1, that is c1 x raised to minus 1 plus c2 x square plus this z as a log x, that is log x by 3 into bracket x square minus x raised to minus 1, which is the solution of the given non-homogeneous equation. Now we will see one more example. Solve x cube dqy by dx cube plus 2x square d square y by dx square is equal to x plus sine of log x. Now clearly this equation is now homogeneous differential equation, and reduce this homogeneous to linear, we can put x equal to e raised to z, that is z is equal to log x, so that we get x square d square y by dx square is equal to d into d minus 1 of y, and x cube dqy by dx cube is equal to d into d minus 1 into d minus 2 of y. Substituting these values in the equation, given equation becomes d into d minus 1 into d minus 2 plus this one 2d into d minus 1 of y is equal to e raised to z plus sin z. Now multiplying these two terms, you get d cube minus 3d square plus 2d, and multiplying this we get 2d square minus 2d of y is equal to e raised to z plus sin z. That is d cube minus 3d square plus 2d square, that is minus d square, and plus 2d minus 2d will get cancelled, of y is equal to e raised to z plus sin z. Now which is a linear equation with constant coefficients. Now its auxiliary equation is given by d cube minus d square equal to 0, that is taking d square common, d square into d minus 1 equal to 0, that is d equal to 0, 0 and 1. Here 0, 0 is repeated, therefore corresponding to this cf we can write into bracket c1 plus c2z, and corresponding to the root 1 we can write c3 e raised to z. Now pi is equal to 1 by f of d, means d cube minus d square of e raised to z plus sin z, which is equal to 1 by d cube minus d square of e raised to z plus 1 by d cube minus d square of sin z. Now here we have separated into two parts. Let us call this first part as a pi1 and this second part as a pi2. Now we will calculate pi separately. First we will consider pi1, that is equal to 1 by d cube minus d square of e raised to z. Now here again we can apply the rule of 1 by f of d of e raised to ax. Here a is 1. If you replace a by 1, then we get 1 minus 1, 0, which is the case of failure. For that we can multiply by z and we take the derivative of d cube minus d square, that is 3d square minus 2d of e raised to z, which is equal to z into, now you can replace d by 1, that is 1 by 3 into 1 square minus 2 into 1 of e raised to z, which is equal to z into e raised to z. Now we'll calculate pi2. Pi2 is 1 by d cube minus d square of sin z, which is equal to, we can write d cube as a 1 by d into d square minus d square of sin z, that we can write, which is equal to 1 by d into minus 1 minus of minus 1 sin z. Since we know 1 by phi of d square of sin ax is equal to 1 by phi of minus a square of sin ax, here a is 1, which is equal to d into minus 1, that is minus d, minus into minus 1, that is plus 1 of sin z. Now here to get in the denominator d square, to apply the rule, we can multiply this by 1 plus d and we can divide by 1 plus d, that is 1 plus d divided by this minus d plus 1 is 1 minus d into 1 plus d of sin z is equal to 1 plus d divided by 1 minus d into 1 plus d is 1 minus d square of sin z, which is equal to 1 plus d, again replacing d square by minus a square, you get 1 minus of minus 1, which is equal to 1 by 2. Now we are operating 1 plus d on sin z, 1 into sin z is sin z plus d of sin z. Here d stands for d by dz, which is equal to 1 by 2 sin z, and d of sin z is, that is derivative of sin z is cos z. Hence the complete solution of equation number 1 is we have y equal to cf plus pi1 and pi2. Now putting z is equal to log x or e raised to z equal to x, we get the solution of the given equation.